Davide Biocchi from Italy. Today is the middle of the week, so it's Wednesday, and we will focus again on all the different asset classes that creates what I call the intermarket situation. So let's start from the crude oil. Today we will have some news about the OPEC Plus, about the number of barrels that they will start to reproduce again in a short term in the future. So the price of a crude oil is remaining in this area around $41 per barrel. This is very interesting because the first support is around $35 per barrel, okay? Next one will be 28, that is here. And I expect that in case of breakout, the target could be $50 per barrel. So the price is very flat in the last market session. We can expect some movement to come, but this is yet to come. So we need to wait. Remaining in the commodities environment, we can switch to the gold. The gold is still is very interesting, but the volatility went down really a lot. So we had the gold for a long time in between these two levels. It was something like a box here, okay? Then there was a breakout. A real breakout of a price of 1,800, but the price remained there. We are very close to the top here, 1,827, if I remember well. But we need to see some very energetic day to understand that everything is doing and going good. So, not so far the situation about the silver. The silver went through the breakout of 19, more or less, $19 per barrel that we can see here. Target is a little bit less, very close to $20 per, sorry, not per barrel, but per ounce. I'm sorry. So the target of $20 per ounce is very close. And I think that the market will go there and will reach this target very soon. Obviously, $19 per ounce will remain the support for it will come back with the price. So let's switch also to another really important metal, that is the copper. So the copper really did a great job. It was very close to $3, that was the target, as we said, because these were the price where in the April of the past year, so 2019, the market found the top for 3-4 times here. So the price arrived here on Monday, but then comes a little bit back. So it's still there, really important price, but it seems that the market is going to get a pause. But this is probably the best chart that we have in the commodities environment. So let's go to the euro dollar, because we have a movement that went through since the last 2 days. That is going into the situation that we highlighted several times. This is a pennant, this is a flag. If you remember well, I was explaining that in case of breakout of a flag, the overtaking of 114 will drive to 114, and we were here, and now we overtake also this resistance that came from here, and we are now directed probably to 115. Why the euro is so strong with the dollar? Well, don't forget that this is really an advantage for the US companies that can export their production with the most interesting price for the European people if the euro will remain so strong. Don't forget also that we normally have a look at the dollar also against different currencies. In this case, we can see that the 1.26 resistance on the pound is really working actively. So we have the market unable to overtake this level that will launch the pound versus towards 1.28. So we can expect that in case of breakout here, but the price is still remaining here. So let's see also the situation that we have comparing the US dollar with the Australian dollar. That is still in the box, but trying to break out the resistance. Okay, this is something really interesting that we will see probably in the next market session. Let's also have a look at the New Zealand dollar. Well, one end is missing, but I will come immediately. Here we are. No, not yet. Okay, New Zealand dollar versus US dollar. So it was very close to a breakout, but it didn't happen. So the resistance is 0.66, a little bit less. We can expect the market to do that, but for the moment, there was a trial, but the trial was not successful. So this is something that will probably work again in the future. Finally, let's see the situation that we have comparing the US dollar to the Canadian dollar. And what I can see here is that we have something like a sort of box, okay? This is a very clear box. The market is going up and down since the first half of June, up and down into in between these two levels. I can expect it to grow or to go down when we will see the moment it will exit from this box. So finally, we are now focusing on the stock indices. The first of all is the Nasdaq. Well, what we have seen is that the Nasdaq went up really strong, very close to the target of 11,200 and something. That is the target of the head and shoulder that we can clearly see here in the chart. Okay, so the target was quite reached, but looking at what happened, we have a shadow here over 11,000, and then the market reacted very bad. So what it seems, looking yesterday, is that the market is going to get a trend inversion. But what happened yesterday was completely changing the landscape. Okay, so the situation is that this candle tells us about the possibility that the market can go down, okay, can have a retracement. But this one told us that the market is going to change again the trend. So this is a very strong buying signal. And as you can see, both this candle, but especially yesterday's one, were done with really good volume. So it's really interesting to see. So the Nasdaq continues to be very strong, and the target is probably to reach the previous maximum. Well, imagine also that over this level or under this level, we can have a very nice trend. But until the moment the market will be remain in between, we will be something like a sideway here, okay? So the situation of the Nasdaq is really strong. The S&P 500 is not as strong as the Nasdaq, but very close to the price of 3,230 that represent a very strong resistance. Not so far the situation of the DAX. The DAX is very close to 13,000. And what does it mean, 14,000 for the DAX? It will mean to go back to the situation that was pre-COVID-19, so previously than COVID-19. So this is a very interesting situation. Let's see if the DAX will be able to overtake this very important level. Let's see also what is going to happen with the Euro Stoxx 50. Let me say that we are here. The Euro Stoxx 50 is not as strong as the S&P 500 and the DAX are, because the Euro Stoxx 50 is something like a melting pot where inside you have the most important stocks, including the Italian one and the Spanish one that are in more difficulty. So let me say that here we have the price very close to the resistance of 3,400. In case of breakout, the target could be 3,600, that is the pre-COVID-19 price, okay? But more or less, we can see also that 3,200, this is here, this is the main support that we can see around here. Finally, we can have a look also at the Italian index. The Italian index is not doing as good as the US indices or the DAX are doing. It's growing, but not with the same strength, okay? So we can see here that there was a quite strong movement, then flat, then again strong, and then again flat. So the resistance here is 20,400, and we can expect it to be reached, and then we will see what is going to happen. We can see also this series of increasing minimums, so I think that we can expect a test around this level. So this is all for this week. This is Wednesday, so middle of the week. This is Davide Biocchi from Italy. See you soon. Ciao, ciao. Bye-bye.